Got my baby bottle. Remind me to tell you something. Hello, welcome to our show. My name is Christy Mendoza, and I have been honored to work with 15 of the most amazing ladies the past 2.5 months on this production. And we are just so thrilled to have you here today. So thank you for coming. This will be our first evening production. We were really praying that the sun would go behind those clouds because it did get a little bright in here just a minute ago, but the Lord knows best, so we'll leave it in His capable hands.
Amen.
I had someone the last couple of times, a couple of weeks, I've had a couple different people ask me, what's the name of your production company that's doing this? You know, this is some being asked. We don't have a name. That's too formal for us. We're just kind of just throwing it together. But to give you a little background, some of you weren't here last year. This started in the basement of our house, actually, with my daughters doing a scene of Tangled. And from there, it blossomed to, hey, let's put on a show. We did a production of Tangled a year ago today, or yesterday. On Saturday, we did a production of Tangled. We had a cast of 8 amazing girls. And this year, we have nearly doubled in size with a cast of 15. And we have definitely quadrupled in size in our props, I will tell you that, as you will see as the show progresses. So we are so, so very happy that you're here. And although we do not have a name for our production company, we do have a mission statement that I want to share with you. We have always made sure that we had the two main things in mind. One was to make sure that everything that we did was glorifying and edifying to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That was always primary to us. And secondarily, to have fun while doing it. And I know that we've achieved the latter, and I pray that we've achieved the former as well. So we are happy that you're here. If you look at the back of your program, I want to share with you what our theme verse was as we worked on this production. This verse is used in the play. You'll see that we did change some of the dialogue that Disney put together to add a little scripture in there, and this verse is actually used in the production. For those of you that have seen Frozen, you'll probably recognize why we chose this verse, but I won't give it away for everybody. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. And that was just our theme verse that we wanted to use throughout this show. So hope that you enjoy that. We obviously don't charge admission. We don't want to charge admission to this show. We do have a concession stand that you're welcome to enjoy during intermission and after. That is all donation basis. Any money that we raise is going to be used for 2 things. That's why I hold a baby bottle. This half of the money that we raise is going to go to the Open Arms Real Choices Pregnancy Crisis Center, which is here in Coeur d'Alene, and they are in an abortion alternative clinic. And so they do amazing work here in Coeur d'Alene and Spokane and Surface area. So they are a very worthy organization that we support. And so half the money is raised for that. We'll go to that. The other half we're going to put in a kitty for next year's props. If we do move on with the show for next year, whatever that might be, we thought we'd start a kitty for that. It's making it sound more formal all the time, isn't it? Anyway, we're just really happy that you're here. If you would take a moment to silence your cell phones, we would appreciate that. You just never know, someone might just start dancing to the tune you have playing, so it would be better if they stuck to the program. So we will get started, and I am so thrilled to have you here. Enjoy the show. go.
God for his guidance, fear will be your enemy.
We will help guide her. We will look to God to teach us how to use her ability. Until then, we will lock the gates. We'll reduce the staff. We will limit her contact with people and keep her abilities hidden from everyone, including Anna.
Thank you.
courage, and I'm trying to. I'm right out here for you, just let me in. We only have each other, it's just you and me. What are we gonna do? Do you wanna build a snowman?
Show. Make one wrong move and everyone will go. looking where I was going, but I'm fine. Actually.
Oh, thank goodness. Prince Hans of Southern Isles.
Princess Anna of Arendelle.
Princess?
My lady.
Oh, this is awkward. Not you're awkward just because I'm awkward. I'd like to formally apologize for slamming into the Princess of Arendelle and for every moment after.
Oh, no, it's fine. I'm not that sort of princess. I mean, if you hit my sister,
I'll see
you. Because, you know. But luckily for you, it's just me.
Just you.
Coronation, I have to go. I better go. Bye.
Thank you. I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate coffee.
But with you, I see your face, and it's nothing like I've ever known before. Love's an open door. Love's an open door. Love's an open door with you. With you. Love's an open door.
I'm crazy.
What?
We fit each other.
Sandwiches.
Right.
I never met someone who thinks so much like me. Cheeks, cheeks again. Our mental synchronization can't have but one explanation. And that I were just meant to be. Say goodbye to the pain of the past. We don't have to feel it anymore. Love's an open door.
Thank you. She couldn't have tried.
topical abilities that turn the fjords into white sand and warm fire.
Am I dreaming? It's a building!
Thank you.
know, Sven, I didn't get your parents. But I did find just a place to sleep, and it's free.
People will beat you and curse you and chase you. Everyone loves them except you.
Thanks,
buddy.
You snub and the don't you think I'm right?
That's only true for all except you.
You got me. Let's call it a night.
Good night.
Don't let the frost bite.
Take me up the North Mountain. I don't take people places. Let me rephrase that. Oh, hey! Take me up the North Mountain. Please. Look, I know how to stop this winter. You leave it, Dawn. And you forgot the carrots you spend. We leave. Now. Right now. Hang on, I like to go fast.
I like fast.
Whoa. Get your feet down. This is fresh lager. Seriously, were you raised in a barn?
No, I was raised in a castle.
So tell me, what made the Queen Ghoul ice crazy?
Oh, well, I guess it was all my fault. You see, I got engaged, but then she freaked out because I only just met him, you know, like that day, and she said she wouldn't bust the marriage.
Wait, you got engaged to someone you just met that day?
Yeah, so I got mad, and so she got mad, and so she tried to walk away, and I grabbed her glove.
Hang on! You mean to tell me that you got engaged to someone you just met that day?
Yes, pay attention. But the thing is, she wore the gloves all the time. So I just thought maybe she has a thing about dirt.
Didn't your parents ever warn you about strangers?
Yes, they did. But Hans is not a stranger.
Oh yeah? What's his last name?
Of the Southern Isles.
What's his favorite food?
Sandwiches.
Best friend's name?
Probably John.
Eye color?
Dreamy.
Foot size?
Foot size does not matter.
Have you had a meal with him yet? What if you hate the way he eats? What if you hate the way he picks his nose?
Picks his nose?
And eats it.
Excuse me, sir. He's a prince.
All men do it.
Ew. It doesn't matter. It's true love.
Doesn't sound like true love.
Are you some sort of love expert?
No, but I have friends who are.
You have friends who are love experts. I'm not buying it. Stop talking. No, really. I want to meet the...
I mean it.
Shh.
Sven, go! Go! I got this. You just don't bluff and don't. sled and everything in it. And I understand if you don't want to help me anymore.
Of course I don't want to help her anymore. In fact, this whole thing has ruined me for helping anyone else ever again. But she'll die on her own. I can live with that. But you won't get useless, she did. You know, sometimes I really don't like you. Hold up, we're coming.
You are? I mean, sure, I'll let you tag along.
Drink in my hand, my snow against the burning sand, probably getting worse than sand in summer. I finally see a summer breeze blow away over the storm. I know what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense, put them together, it just makes sense. Winter's a pretend to stay in the cuddle. Look at summer and I'll be a happy snowman. Hold on to my dream, relaxing in the summer sun, just letting all steam. When I finally do, you're first to do, it's summer!
I'm gonna tell you. Don't you dare.
It's summer!
And that came out great. But we could not have done this with all the families involved, and I'm so, so thankful to all the parents who sent their kids, brought their kids, all of that. So I just wanted to thank each family, the Buchan family, thank you so much for sending Olivia all these days. The Paul family, oh my goodness, Kelly Paul made these wonderful, well, all the Paul family had a part in building the castles and the snowflakes, and many of the props that you're seeing here are courtesy of the Pauls. The LaParte family also, she said to me, you know, if I'd known what I was signing up for, like, that's what happens when God gives you a talent of creativity, I'm going to use it. And we did. The Hughes family, furthest travelers come all the way from Apple every single day, or every single practice we had, so they get the travel award, and we set up all downstairs. We had sewing machines and glue guns and all sorts of things working, so just many thanks to them. And I know I'm forgetting someone. The Ward family who made this wonderful backdrop. And I let me tell you what goes on behind that thing when you guys aren't watching. It is so much fun. When you see tour people dancing out here, they're singing their hearts out back there. Lip syncers galore. It's really quite fun. So we're happy to have that curtain because it hides a lot. Anyway, I'm so happy to have you all here. I hope you're enjoying the show. Let's get back to the second.
Is that a lost mom?
Your wife is a natural too.
Yeah.
Cloak, does anyone need a cloak?
Arendelle is indebted to you, Your Highness.
The castle is open. There's soup and hot grog in the great hall.
Prince Hans, do you just all expect us to sit here and all freeze to death while you move away all Arendelle's trade book goods?
Princess Anna has given her orders.
And that's another thing. Has it dawned you that your princess may be conspiring with her sister to kill us all?
Do not question the princess. She has left me in charge, and I will not hesitate to protect Arendelle from treason.
Treason?
Prince Hans. Princess Anna's horse was returned from the mountain, alone. Princess Anna's in trouble. I need volunteers to come with me to help find her.
I volunteer too, men, my lord. May you be prepared for anything you are to encounter the queen while you are at it. You are to put an end to this winter. Understand?
Hey guys! Not sure this is gonna solve the problem, but I found a staircase leading exactly where you wanna go.
Aha! Thank goodness!
So how exactly are you planning to solve this winter?
Oh, I am going to talk to my...
That's your plan? My hypothesis is letting on you talking to your sister?
Yep.
So you're not at all afraid of her?
Why should I be?
Yeah, I bet she's the nicest, gentlest, warmest person ever. Oh, look at that. I've been impaled.
That's ice.
I might cry. Go ahead. I won't judge.
All right, buddy, take it easy. I gotcha. Now you just stay right here. Flawless. Knock.
Just knock. Why isn't she knocking? Do you think she even knows how to knock?
Hey, it's open.
You better wait out here.
What? Last time I introduced you to a guy, she froze everything.
Oh, but come on! It's a palace made of ice! Ice is my life!
Bye, Sven! You too, Olaf.
Good.
Me? Just give us a minute.
Okay.
One, two, three, four.
Leave me be. Yes, I'm alone, but I'm alone.
dirt everywhere.
Everywhere?
It's okay, you can just unfreeze it.
No, I can't. I don't know how.
Sure you can. I know you can.
Because for the first time in
love experts? And don't worry, they'll be able to fix this.
How do you know?
Because I've seen them do it before.
I'd like to consider myself a love expert.
Yeah. lovely wedding.
Wait, what?
You're getting married.
No!
Anna, she's as cold as ice. Something bad has happened here.
Anna, your life is in danger. There is ice in your heart put there by your sister. If not removed to solid ice, you will freeze forever.
What? No, but can't it be removed?
As it says in the Bible, greater love hath no man than this, that a man may lay down his life for his friends. What this tells us is that only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
An act of true love? A true love's kiss, perhaps.
Anna, we need to get you back to Hans.
Hans?
Come on, Sven. Come on, Olaf.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
if anything happens to the princess. You're all Arendelle has left.
He's in here. Prince Hans.
Anna, why are you so cold?
Hans, you have to kiss me.
What? No.
We'll give you two some privacy.
What happened out there?
Elsa struck me with her powers.
She said she never hurt you.
I was wrong.
Anna. She froze my heart, and only an act of true love can save me. My true love's kiss.
Oh, Anna.
Well, there's someone out there who loves you. But you said you did.
I stood you in line. I did stand a chance. I knew I'd have to marry to the phone somewhere.
But what are you talking about?
As heir, Elsa was comfortable, of course, but no one was getting anywhere with her. But you.
Hans!
You're so desperate for love, you're willing to marry me. That.
I figured after we married, I'd have to stay to go text me for Elsa.
But then she doomed herself when you were dumb enough to go after her.
Well, it's like now, just kill Elsa and bring back Summer.
You're no match for Elsa.
No, you are no match for Elsa.
I, on the other hand, am the hero who's going to save Arendelle from destruction. You will get through this.
Go on.
I already have.
She died in my arms.
There can be no doubt now. Queen Elsa is a monster, and we are all in grave danger. Prince Hans, Arendelle looks to you.
With a heavy heart, I charge Queen Elsa of Arendelle with treason and sentence her to death.
So, where's Hans? What happened to your kiss?
I was wrong about him. It wasn't true love.
But we ran all the way here.
Please, Ola, you can't stay here. You'll melt.
I am not leaving here until we find some other act of true love to save you.
Do you happen to have any ideas?
I don't even know what love is.
That's okay. I do. Love is putting someone else's needs before yours. You know, like how Christoph brought you here to Hans and left you forever.
Christoph loves me?
Wow, you really don't know anything about love, do you?
Ola, you're melting.
Some people are worth it. Just maybe not right this second. But we are gonna find some other act of true love to save you. But it's Christoph and Sven! They're coming back this way!
They are?
Wow, he's really moving fast. I guess I was wrong. I guess Christoph doesn't love you enough to leave you behind.
Please.
No, you need to stay by the fire and keep warm.
I have to get to Christoph.
Why? Oh, I know why! There's your actor true love right there!
Riding across the fjord like a valiant pungent reindeer king!
Love will thaw. Love.
quite possibly the last.
Oh, hang in there, little guy.
Oh, oh.
My own personal flurry!
Thank you.